the electric generator went off at the Moreno family farm, so everybody decided to go to bed early.
Estamos casi fuera de partidos.
With their husbands off on a routine military mission, they're alone on the farm. And now there's trouble.
Suddenly, Dora, the domestic servant, she bursts into the room.
Vi las luces extrañas.
She tells them that there's something strange going on outside.
The maid was working at that residence for quite some time, and she was a very calm person.
Hay máquinas.
Máquinas?
So her behavior was considered very unusual by the sisters, who never saw her so afraid with something, especially with something that she couldn't describe.
The key thing that Dora was trying to get out to the sisters was that there was more than just lights. There were actual machines outside and quite close to the house.
Their first thought is it might be a guerrilla jeep or tank.
It just wasn't clear what kind of machine she was talking about.
Yoli and Yolanda, they saw nothing. The maid was pretty sure that the lights were coming from the railroad. So they went in that direction.
Dora is still very, very frightened. There was some sort of thought that maybe somebody was doing acts of sabotage down on the railway tracks, and one of them's armed with a gun.
They reach a lookout with the railroad tracks a kilometer in the distance. And finally see Dora's machine.
Madre mía!
Something strange that they couldn't explain.
If it's a vehicle, it's not one they've ever seen before.
They saw these two disc-shaped objects profoundly illuminated with a tube of light uniting the two objects like a light tunnel.
There was this sort of heightened sense of danger that they weren't sure what they were dealing with.
Yulie decides to move closer.
They didn't have a clear vision.
¿A dónde vas? ¿Dónde está la luz?
They wanted to get close to the railroad to see what it really was.
Yulie, espera, frena. ¿Dónde está la luz?
They see what appears to be a familiar sight.
They're aware of a sort of a faint green illumination.
¿Es ese el camión de Rodrigo?
They thought that could be the caretaker's truck coming to the house. When Yoli pointed her flashlight, the green light that she saw, this was not a truck at all.
This was a completely different object from the railway line.
It was huge, 10 meters at least.
The object seemed to have rectangular windows around its circumference.
Usually, when something has windows, it's because there is somebody inside of them.
And then, the object emits a bizarre light beam.
The progression of that beam of light is most unusual, like the lightsabers used in Star Wars. You know, you see them pop out and slowly, suddenly progress into a solid light tube. Light that seems to behave in ways that our sort of beams of light don't behave in.
Yulie is mysteriously drawn to the beam.
And she put her hand into it.
Yulie, no!
When you put your hand into a beam of light, you just interrupt the beam of light. In this, there seemed to be no change at all to this unusual beam of light.
She felt a heat around her arm, but didn't cause any burn or anything.
Then, the object's behavior changes.
There seemed to be this sort of mist developing around this object.
Whatever this mist is, Dora is drawn to it.
The object seemed to then rock noticeably.
While they are watching this object, some light inside of it started to spin, to rotate, until the whole thing became orange.
And suddenly, out of the bottom of this object burst this sort of tongue of fire.
This huge object knocked them down a few meters away, violently.
The impact on the three women was total fear. At that point, they all did what most people would have done, and that was to flee back to the house.
The disc-shaped object started to scan the property.
They clearly believed that they were under threat, under attack.
Then the beam of light suddenly disappears.
This whole thing lasted from 45 to 50 minutes, according to the primary UFO researchers in Argentina that investigated this case back in 1963.
Once the objects disappear, Yolie and Yolanda Moreno meet with a neighbor who describes seeing what he calls weird light activity over their property. On the same night, a doctor whose car broke down halfway between the Moreno farm and the town of Trancas reports seeing approximately 50 strange lights flying overhead. While the case receives wide attention in the press, skeptics attack the fact that descriptions of the object seem to vary slightly from witness to witness. 14 years later, the Trancas incident becomes one of the inspirations for Steven Spielberg's film, Close Encounters of the Third Kind.